AI-generated ads and banners might look cool today, but you still need it to finalize it somewhere else. Why? Text and logos. You want those two to be untouched, and it's not that easy to control with AI. It could be done, but now it got way easier. And I will show you how I did that. The only thing you need is a photo of a product. And maybe also one more thing. Now, this is the workflow, and it flows basically fairly simple. The only thing you need is an image of your product. In my case, those are coffee pots and coffee machine. Then I prepared one, which is a box, to show you how it works. And also you need an image of a style that you would like your ad to look like. So the logic of the workflow is like this. You upload your image and you let LLM to describe your product. And then you will upload your desired look or at least some inspiration, and you will get a description of environment, lighting setups, elements that are in here. For example, these are like fabric of brown and gold color, I guess. And LLM is prompt not to reference any product in it. It just needs to take out the style of how does it look. And now we have basically two descriptions, one for product, one for desired look. And you will plug those two into prompt concatenator, where you can see I have the description of the product plugged in, then description of a style plugged in, and I added one more prompt, which is create a banner of product, which I plugged as the first one. What this node does is it actually sequences all those prompts one after another, and you will get one that is kind of complete. And you also have some space to add some maybe additional info if you want. I just added no text on the ad because this is the best thing on this workflow, that you can get that in quite easily. And now I used Nano Banana, which gave me this image. Of course, with different product, different pot, it was like this. And with the coffee machine, it looked like this. Sometimes the product is quite big, sometimes it's smaller or medium in here, but you can work with every single one as long as you like the visuals. So the next step was to plug it into Upscaler so I get more pixels in. You can see it's 2048 by 2048, and is the case for every single one. And now I wanted it to be as a portrait, 9x16, because I aimed to use that for reels. So there are two main ways what you can do, and you need to decide on that based on the image that you have. In here, I cannot easily crop it because there is just not enough environment around the product. So I used outpaint node, where I just plugged in the image. In here, I did a mistake because I plugged in the original version, not upscaled one, but it would work just as fine with both. And I only wrote to generate 400 pixels above and 400 pixels below. And it added this part here and this part here. But with those two in here, I actually had enough of a space around, therefore I could easily crop it. In here, I used crop node. I set it up to 9x16 and then positioned in here just as well. And now I was basically prepared to create my videos. I used Seedance, but you can try any other video models. Cling would work just fine. You can see that I aimed for fairly simple motion. I used really simple prompt, product animation, camera slowly moving sideways and zooming in, product is still in focus. This way I got three generations. With every single product, I think it was second or third try that I was actually happy with. And now what is cool here is that Weavy recently introduced new feature into their compositor node, and it is really cool because now it can actually work with videos, which wasn't the case a week ago. So what I did was I plugged video into compositor in every single one as a first layer, and then I just uploaded logo from the internet, sticker, and three simple text nodes. I plugged those into compositor as input nodes, and with this you just click edit and you can work just like with Photoshop here, simplified, but it works. There are text layers, image layers. With text you can pick the font size. Once you are happy, you can position it however you want it, hit X, and this way you have your AI generated ad with text and logos untouched. These two areas were still kind of a tricky part to get right, because you can prompt it not to touch the text or logo, but still some morphing happens. However, this approach is simple, clean, direct, and basically it works. In here, I plug just logo and two text layers, and same here. This one is kind of slow, I think, but I could just easily speed it up in a post. So let's take a look at how does it work with this box. I can copy all those nodes, Control C, Control V, and I will plug the box in here and delete this one. So let it describe. You can see description changed and our prompt concatenator got updated. But we are still missing one node here, which is this one with the description of a style. So let's plug it in. And you can see we have our full prompt. Now I need to drag this image also as image reference to Nano Banana. However, maybe to save some time, I can delete this part and prompt Nano Banana to give me 9x16 already. And let's hit run, or we can let it run 4 times from the beginning. And let's take a look. I don't like this one. This one is kind of cool. This is weird, but we could basically erase it and let it outpaint again, no problem with that. And this one is also kind of interesting. It prompted in like a source of light, but we could fix this really easy. But I like this one the most because the product is still quite big. I can let it upscale, maybe to download it as a image banner. And while this is being generated, I can bring in Seedance, where I will use Pro version, and I will plug upscale version as a first frame, and we can drag this simple prompt in here. And now let's hit run and wait. So our video is ready. It moves a little bit too much, but as a showcase, it's fine. Now we have our video. Let's bring in compositor and I will plug this as a background. Now I will add a couple of inputs. I will bring in the logo, doesn't matter into which one you will plug it. Then one text. And since I don't see that, I will use this one here. And now it looks like this, which is nothing like what I showed you before. But you need to do some adjustments. Let's hit edit and we can select logo, scale it down, bring it, for example, in here. And now let's use layer one. I will use Montserrat. It will be white. And I don't know, let's try 70. Let's align it into center and bring it somewhere here. Then second one, again, Montserrat, black. I will use white color, maybe 50. Again, align it into the center. And now just make it bigger, right? 70, 90. I will just eyeball it. Okay, that's fine. And now you have your AI-generated ad kind of a quickly. And now you are basically done, but you probably would want to download the video, which you cannot do here since it's Compositor. But for that, you need one more node, which is export, and you will plug output there and you can just click download and it will render it out and you are done. So check the workflow in the comments. It's there. You can play with it, make tweaks, make it better, whatever you want.